Top 10 reasons not to move to Seattle. Ah, Seattle. The City of Goodwill. The Emerald City. The gateway to Alaska. It's interesting how this city has so many nicknames, but not even all of these nicknames can save its residents from the poor quality of life that they have to endure. More like City of Earthquakes, Volcanoes, Horrible Weather, and residents who don't have a single ounce of goodwill for newcomers. Don't get me wrong, Seattle's one of the fastest growing cities, and it's got a lot to offer, like good food, high quality education, Starbucks, and the famous gum wall, but that's just about everything that the city has to offer. It's a city that you're better off visiting for a few weeks, as being a resident here is not that great. From terrible traffic to devastating natural disasters and high cost of living, here's 10 reasons why moving to Seattle is a terrible idea. Number 10, gloomy weather. If the beautiful landscape is what's attracting you to Seattle, then you might want to think again. The weather in Seattle is always cloudy and dreary and a tad bit depressing, which is why they drink a lot of coffee to help them get through the day. You would have to deal with more than 150 days of rain each year. And although they're not usually serious rainstorms, it's rainy enough to get you soaking wet and mess your day up. The residents of Seattle are so used to the rain that nobody even goes out with umbrellas anymore. You just wing it. With weather like this and cloudy days for more than two-thirds of the year, the beautiful lakes and mountains are just foggy shapes in the distance. You might get to see the beauty of the city in the summer, but summer only lasts for a couple of months and everybody's back to their dark, dreary lives. So be prepared to go months without seeing the sun and having a drug cabinet full of vitamin D pills. Number 9, too close to nature. There is no doubt Seattle's a paradise for lovers of nature, but all that proximity to nature comes with its own disadvantages. While you have enough space to go camping and hiking, you can't escape coming in contact with animals like bears, which are known to enter campsites in search of food, and maybe a little bit of entertainment, but hey, who knows? So don't be surprised if you come back and meet a bear in your tent casually going through your stuff. It's all part of the experience in Seattle. You'd also have to end up dealing with a million bugs and flies, especially mosquitoes, which can get you sick if you're not careful. But don't worry, Seattle has an amazing healthcare system, so you can stay healthy while you're there. Number 8, Seattle Freeze. Aside from having one of the biggest ports in America, Seattle is also one of the biggest tech hotspots in the US, and that means more than half of the people living in the city aren't indigents. While this is a good sign that the city's growing, not everybody is happy about the massive influx of strange people to the city. This ends up making native Seattleans to be a bit less welcoming towards newcomers in the city, and it gets worse if they get to know that you're in the tech industry. I'm sure you know why. Ironically, there is no goodwill in the City of Goodwill, so if you're one whose emotions are tied to how people treat you, your first days in Seattle are not going to be the happiest. You'll be near ostracized, and there's not going to be any smiling neighbors waving as you drive by or show up at your door with warm apple pies. Number 7, the high cost of living. As one of the biggest cities in America, Seattle is home to dozens of Fortune 500 companies and some of the richest and biggest tech startups, which means that there are plenty of well-paying jobs. That's good, right? Wrong. The high income has driven the cost of living to over 50% more than the national average, and that number is still growing. Everything ends up leaving a hole in your pocket, from transportation to groceries, utilities, and even coffee, despite it being the coffee capital of the world. However, on the bright side, income tax is not much of a thing in Seattle, but that doesn't mean you're safe. The tax rate for Seattle is about 10%. Which is higher than most cities in the country, because you get taxed on everything, including soda. Seattle will drain you, and there's nothing that you can do about it. Number 6, bad drivers. Driving in Seattle is war, and maybe that's why you have some of the most erratic and unpredictable drivers in Seattle, because, I mean, you can't let your enemies know your next move in a war, right? The struggle to go from one point to another in Seattle is one that you'd want to avoid, because you would meet all kinds of crazy drivers in Seattle. There are ones in a hurry to be somewhere, and they keep zigzagging their way through traffic. There's also ones who have nowhere to be, so they end up going 40 in a 60. Plus, not to mention that you have the ones that just leave the car to drive itself while they doze off behind the steering wheel, and worst of all, the ones driving high on marijuana. It's crazy out there, folks. Number 5, natural disasters. Seattle is quite the eye-catcher when it comes to the beauty, but it's still susceptible to natural disasters, which would want to make you remain there. Why? Look, it ranks number 1 in the country when it comes to natural disasters, and is prone to over 18 hazards, including winter storms, flooding, landslides, earthquakes, and, the scariest of all, volcanoes. Located just 60 miles outside Seattle is Mount Rainier, which is ranked in the top 3 of the most dangerous volcanoes in America. Although it hasn't erupted in a long time, it's still considered an active hydrothermal system, which means that, if it blows, it's likely to cover half the city in molten lava should the mountain cough. Seattle is also located on several fault lines, which makes it prone to frequent earthquakes. Aside from the destruction that these earthquakes can cause, they can also trigger a volcanic eruption in Mount Rainier. You sure you still want to go to Seattle? Number 4, terrible traffic. Home to over 4 million residents, Seattle is getting terribly overcrowded, and more people are still moving to Seattle. In 2019 alone, over 150,000 people moved to Seattle, and more would have moved this year too. As a result, you've got several cars trying to fit into Seattle's narrow expressway at a time, causing the road to get choked up. Reports have shown that an average resident will end up spending at least 55 hours in traffic every year. Seattle does have buses and train services, but they are as useful as the numerous nicknames the city has. However, if you are lucky and your workplace or school is within spitting distance, be prepared to go up and down several hills due to the annoyingly hilly terrain. But hey, on the bright side, you'll end up with some strong calf muscles, which is one of the most attractive things in the world. Number 3, too many chickens. Okay, this one sounds right out of left field, like it's out of some bizarro cartoon, but yes, this is a real problem. A lot of families in Seattle rear chickens in their backyard, so it's normal to hear a rooster first thing in the morning, or come across more than one professional chicken coop builder. This can end up causing the neighborhood to get real noisy, and you can't really complain, else you'll get an hour-long lecture on the benefits of farm-fresh eggs and chickens. It ended up getting so bad that the state of Seattle had to restrict the number of chickens that you're even allowed to keep and banned roosters out entirely. Number 3, real estate's a fortune. In a city that is this populated, the demand for real estate is high, which has raised the prices astronomically as well. Now, while you still can get houses in other major cities for an average of $200,000 or $300,000, in Seattle, be prepared to pay nearly $700,000, and that's just for a single-family home. Rent is pegged at an average of somewhere in the ballpark of $2,100 per month, but don't be expecting some millionaire penthouse-sized suite with that kind of number. Most of those apartments are easily going to be less than 1,000 square feet. With a limited amount of livable space in the city, as well as the high cost of living, it's not a surprise that the homeless is on the rise in Seattle, with more than 15,000 individuals living on the streets or in their cars. Number 1, high crime rate. With a high rate of homelessness and the legalization of weed in the city, not only does Seattle have a drug problem, but crime has been on the rise, especially in the poorest of areas. Seattle's police department also isn't as effective as it used to be, after a record number of police officers resigned in September, including the police chief, Carmen Best, after the city council voted a $100 million budget cut. This means that in the coming years, unfortunately, the Seattle Police Department is going to be understaffed and under-equipped, as well as being spread far too thin, making them less effective in many scenarios. So there you have it. Those are the reasons why you don't want to move to Seattle.